Welcome to A Spirited Debate. I'm Lauren Green. Last November, 29-year-old Brittany Maynard ended her own life taking a doctor-prescribed suicide pill. Maynard suffered from terminal brain cancer and made headlines by moving to Oregon, where assisted suicide is legal. Fighting to stop Maynard from carrying out her plans was a woman who has spent almost her entire life in a wheelchair after a diving accident left her a quadriplegic. Johnny Erickson Tada pleaded with Brittany to no avail, but Johnny continues her fight against euthanasia, which she says is gaining more and more support. Johnny's Christian ministry fights for the disabled, and she joins me now in studio. Welcome for being here. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Good to be back here.
You know, what did you try to say to Brittany to change her mind?
Well, Lauren, life is the most irreplaceable and fundamental condition of the human experience. And to destroy it without thinking twice and thinking three or four or five times about the implications, it's such a final exit. It's such a final and a fatal solution to one's pain or fear of the future. I know when I was 17 years old and I broke my neck, I was a quadriplegic. My hands don't work, my feet don't walk. And when the doctors told me that this was my prognosis, I would be a quadriplegic, stuck in a wheelchair without using my hands for the rest of my life, I used to wrench my head violently back and forth on the pillow, hoping to break my neck up at a higher level because I so hated the idea. I was so fearful of the future. I didn't want to live this way. I didn't want to encounter the pain. And I'm just so grateful there were no assisted suicide laws back then, which may have made it a possibility for me to procure that wish.
Because so many people would have had sympathy for you. Of course, you know, her life has all ended because she's this, you know, virulent, you know, this athlete, and now she doesn't have that anymore.
Yep, absolutely. And no one would think it was a wrong thing for a quadriplegic to do. Unfortunately, many people feel that a quadriplegic who wants to end his or her life makes a rational, reasonable choice. But thankfully, there were people who were praying. Thankfully, there were people who were surrounding my bedside, drawing me up out of social isolation, alleviating my depression, connecting me to reality, and on and on and on. And they began to impart to me hope and the idea that, you know what, with the grace of God, I think I can do this.
You know, the Gallup poll just out recently shows how asked people, should doctors be allowed to help the terminally ill die? The numbers have been gaining numbers. You see this in 1997, 58% said they should, and now it is at 68%. Why do you think these numbers have grown so much?
I think people have a fundamental fear of disability, of terminal disease. They have a fundamental fear of pain. But we need to remember that here in the United States, we already have very good laws in place which provide for good pain management therapies, excellent hospice care. So rather than channeling so many resources into making it possible for despairing people to end their lives because of a poor medical condition, let's pour those resources into improved hospice care, improved palliative care, better pain management therapies, better community support so that people do not feel isolated, so that they understand that there is life after a diagnosis of a terminal illness.
With that in mind, your ministry is actually on a program of the Wheels for the World. What is that about?
Well, as you can guess, when I was first injured, I hated my wheelchair. I mean, I was stuck in bed for a year in that hospital. This was long before good spinal cord injury rehab care. And boy, Lauren, after about a year of being in bed, a wheelchair started to look pretty good to me. It was like, get me out of here. And once I sat up in a wheelchair and was able to look at life from a 90-degree angle and face it forward, I began to see, oh my goodness, I really can do this. And when I started traveling to developing nations on behalf of our ministry to people with disabilities around the world, Johnny and friends, I began meeting thousands of people with disabilities who would drag themselves through the mud and dirt wearing their shoes on their hands because they could not use their legs. And I realized we could give them freedom, we could give them mobility. So we have now delivered over 100,000 wheelchairs around the world, and Bibles, and we do disability ministry training in churches, helping Christians see that, well, cerebral palsy is not a curse from a local witch doctor. We impart truth about disability to many people in developing nations, and we have a goal to reach another 100,000 wheelchairs by the year 2020. I'm excited.
You know, it's so interesting. You've done so much because of the tragedy that happened to you. I mean, is that the irony behind this whole?
That is the best word for it, Lauren, irony. Never, ever. Oh, Lauren, I was the least likely candidate to like life in a wheelchair. As you said, I was athletic. I was on the go. I was never sitting down. And so now that I should be the one that God would use to improve the health and well-being of people with disabilities around the world through our programs at Johnny and Friends, I am just, it's ironic. That's a good word for it. And I'm so grateful to God that he has put me in this extraordinary opportunity, this unique condition to help other people who are as despairing as I once was. Lift people up out of despair. There is hope.
You are such an inspiration to so many people, thousands if not millions of people. Thank you very much, Johnny Erickson Tata.
Absolutely. Good to be with you.
And you want to check out FoxNews.com for more on this story. I'm Lauren Green, and thanks for watching.